Sorry for the delay. Yusuf also mentioned that you were the man to talk to about specialty calls.
Ah, that man. He's a talker. I'm a navigator in the Sultan's Navy, currently on leave to study cartography. But through my soldiering, I've also gained an appreciation for artillery and explosives. And it has served the assassins well. It gives us an edge. I carry many kinds of bombs. For assassins only, of course. Lethal, tactical, diversionary, and a few peculiar casings. Everything you see here is for sale. If you can prove you know how to use it first.
I am eager to learn.
Well, no one is stopping you. Just let me know.
Thank you.
need to reconcile these ancient Greek maps with data from Admiral Columbus. This is like comparing maps of the moon and the earth. What a mess! Ah, Ezio, cheer me up. Let me teach you something.
What about these poison bombs? How lethal are they?
Quite lethal, Tosmo. We distill our poison from the Natura plant. A pretty little flower with a deadly secret. This one kills, slowly but surely. Be very careful, for your sake and for others.
Grazie.
Like ours, we have a special recipe for deep, dark clouds. Throw one of these at your eyes and useless. You must rely on your hearing and any other senses you may have cultivated.
Other senses? What could that mean?
Word gets around, Ezio, that you are a special sort of man. Strange gifts.
Keep it to yourself.
By this Ezio, count on God. A non-lethal method of stopping pursuers.
I like the sound of that.
When I first sailed with my uncle Cameron more than 2 decades ago, we had quite a lot of fun with these in many rowdy ports. In Rhodes, for instance, it was so easy to lure the Hospitallers from their palace posts right into a patch of caltrops. And to see them dancing in the street in a full suit of armor, nothing is more undignified. Right, you'll see.
Thank you.
about your special bomb casings?
Well, I have some sticky resin bags. My uncle Kamal had a wild fondness for them during Verzi's conflict with Venezia. He was a captain in the Ottoman Navy. He liked resin bombs because they stuck to almost any surface. The hulls of large ships, for instance.
I lost many friends in that conflict.
We all did it, Zio. And that war is why I became an assassin. I hate the artificial boundaries our leaders have built between the people.
We fight to end the fighting. It's a sad irony.
It will always be. But perhaps one day we'll not be so sad. Use this wisely.
Thank you.
distance, lest you corrupt my delicate sensibilities.
Oh, I think you will leave.
Of course. Don't blow your hands off, huh?
Thank you. Padişah diz çöken Muhittin Reis, korsan gemisine Osmanlı bayrağını çekti. 1511 yılında Kızıldeniz'e giderken fırtınaya yakalanan amcasını kaybetti.
Did you know that the early Christians used to place east at the top of their maps? They assumed that heaven lay in that direction, beyond Cathay, because that is where the sun appeared every morning. What convenient simplicity, no? With heaven and earth, glass spheres in the sky, and the earth at the center of the universe. Ha! What a load of horse piss. But you are not here to philosophize. What are you looking at?
I need a simple but effective means of distraction.
Then this is the bomb for you. Gives a nice loud burst, luring all soldiers within earshot, right to the source. Have fun.
Thank you.
Perhaps the next will come to appreciate my efforts. Well, how can I help you, Ezio?
Smoke signal bombs. How do they work?
You must know the old saying. When there is smoke, there is fire. These bombs play off that idea. Creating a thick plume of smoke to trick city guards into believing a fire is starting. These bombs are quiet, however. Those who see the smoke will be lured away.
Santo, I will give it a try.
I used my first bow when I was in my late teens. I was sailing the Mediterranean under an unrecognized flag. With my
son, a privateer. Francesi would say corsair.
No, they would say bajo heretic. I do miss the days of rough ocean travel, the sea spray and the rolling waves. One day soon I will take to the sea again. Until then, I'm here for my assassin. Here is your boat. You should take care. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So I had this map. And it's the one that is called the map of the coast of the Black Sea from Istanbul to Garrison. So I went ahead and I measured from Istanbul to Garrison. And that's what I get. 485. All right. To this map, maybe we can use that as a distance reference in other maps, but you know, each map seems to be kind of unique in its own way. It's not up to scale, it seems distorted a bit, but we're gonna see how well this one lines up. So right here is where that split is. Okay, where Istanbul is at, you see right there, boom. I'm thinking that's what this part is. Okay. So, you know, that seems like a good reference point to use. All right. So back down a little bit. We'll pull this up to where it's. Let's stretch it all the way across. Just see if we can match this up at all. Pull back out a little bit. I'll pause it. So right about here is on the left side is Istanbul to Garrison. We need it to overlap just a bit because of that little channel that's right there. And turn it just a bit away. Yeah, it's not. Let's keep trying with it. Maybe it needed to be something more like this. Yeah, I mean, this one doesn't really look like a flood. It seems like it's more of a, as if the water's lower here for some reason than it used to be. See that? It's even green where the coastline's further in. So anyway, that was Istanbul to Garrison. And it does match in certain spots, like right in here. It's very similar. Through here, it kind of has similarities, but nothing really matching up too well. And where this is pointed north is pretty close. See it right there. Right here, right here. It's pretty accurate. So there we go. Let's go.
Yours is not a subtle approach.
See. Sorry for the delay.
Yeah.